Hello students, welcome to our channel Study Well. If you are watching the video for the first time, please subscribe. In this video, we are going to learn the second chapter from the text Hornbill. We are not afraid to die if we can all be together, by Gordon Cook and Alan East. Multiple choice questions from the chapter. At dawn on January 2nd, the waves were gigantic. We were sailing with only a small storm chip and were still making 8 knots. As the ship rose to the top of each wave, we could see endless enormous seas rolling towards us. And the screaming of the wind and spray was painful to the ears. To slow the boat down, we dropped the storm chip and lashed a heavy mooring rope and a loop across the stern. Question number 1. Which figure of speech was used in this line, "The waves were gigantic"? Option A, simile. Option B, oxymoron. Option C, irony. Option D, hyperbole. Here the correct answer is option B, oxymoron. Number 2. Screaming of winds here means option A, sound of wind. Option B, direction of wind. Option C, speed of wind. Option D, stormy wind. Here the correct answer is option A, sound of wind. Number 3. Which kind of fear was evident in the mind of author during the incident given in the extract? Option A, fear of death. Option B, fear of losing his family soon. Option C, fear of shipwreck. Option D, all of the above. Here the correct answer is option C, fear of shipwreck. Number 4. Which of these statements is not true in the context of the given extract? Option A, the author was worried about the safety of his family and the two crew members. Option B, the author's ship, Wave Worker, shows efficiency but soon is heavily damaged. Option C, the author's statement about the Southern Indian Ocean is true. Option D, none of the above. Here the correct answer is option D, none of the above. Question number 2. Water, water everywhere. I could feel that the ship had water below, but I dared not abandon the wheel to investigate. Suddenly, the front hatch was thrown open and Mary appeared. "We are sinking," she screamed. "The decks are smashed. We are full of water." "Take the wheel," I shouted as I scrambled for the hatch. Number 1. Which of the following idioms describes the situation faced by the narrator? Option A, at wind's ends. Option B, in dire straits. Option C, under the pump. Option D, juggling act. Here the correct answer is option B, in dire straits. Number 2. Choose a statement that's not true with reference to the given extract. Option A. The author and his family were saved by another sailors. Option B. The ship was badly damaged by the whale. Option C. The author and his daughter was badly injured. Option D. None of the above. Here the correct answer is option C. The author and his daughter was badly injured. Number 3. Pick out the option in which scrambled has been used as per the extract. Option A. Maybe the alcohol has scrambled his brains. Option B. The children scrambled for the coins. Option C. We scrambled up the nearly perpendicular side of the mountain. I can easily whip you up some scrambled eggs. Answer is option C. We scrambled up nearly perpendicular side of the mountain. Number 3. When I went in to comfort the children, John asked, "Daddy, are we going to die?" I tried to assure him that we could make it. But Daddy, he went on, "We aren't afraid of dying if we can all be together. You and Mummy, Sue and I." What effect did John's statement have upon the author? Option A. Determination, strength and resolution. Option B. Regret and desperation. Option C. Sorrow and resignation. Option D. A combination of desperation and determination. Here the correct answer is option A. Determination, strength and resolution. Number 4. What's true regarding the given extract? Option A. It shows resignation to the circumstances. Option B. It shows the unity felt by the family. Option C. It shows the courage shown by Sue and John. Option D. All of the above. The correct answer is option D. All of the above. Choose the theme which best matches Iron's statement. Option A. Acceptance. Option B. Reflection. Option C. Retraction. Option D. Sentimentality. Here the correct answer is option A. Acceptance. The phrase ominous silence in the story means option A. Pleasant and soothing silence. Option B. Agreeable and distant silence. Option C. Pleasant and aggressive silence. Option D. Unpleasant and threatening silence. Here the correct answer is option D. Unpleasant and threatening silence. But then, tremendous explosion shook the deck. The given line is an indication of option A, the drowning of the ship. Option B, the damage caused to the ship. Option C, the breaking of the whale. Option D, the thunder of the rain. Here the correct answer is option C, the breaking of the whale. Subsequent verbs toss me around the deck like a rag doll. Choose the option with the correct reference to the textual statement given above. Option A. The water had not only injured the author, but also damaged the ship. Option B. It was difficult for the author to swim through the water. Option C. The author had to take hold of the steering to get the ship to a good position. Option D. The author felt powerless and was on the verge of losing unconscious. Here the correct answer is option B. It was difficult for the author to swim through the water. The great wave had put our auxiliary engine out of action. In the given lines, auxiliary doesn't correspond to option A, alternative, option B, spare, option C, supplement, option D, complement. Here the correct answer is option D, complement. Why did the author decide to go for a round the world voyage? Option A, to duplicate the voyage made 200 years ago by Captain James Cook. Option B, to see the world. Option C, to settle down in different country. Option D, to show his children the world through ship. The correct answer is option A, to duplicate the voyage made 200 years ago by Captain James Cook. What was the name of the ship of the author? Option A, Amazon. Option B, Wave Walker. Option C, Wave Ship. Option D, Sailor Ship. Here the correct answer is option B, Wave Walker. Number 10. Where did they decide to reach to save themselves and the ship? Option A, Australia. Option B, Isle Amsterdam. Option C, Mumbai. Option D, Japan. Here the correct answer is option B, Isle Amsterdam. Thanks for watching. For more informative videos, do subscribe my channel Study Well. Please share, like and comment. Thank you.